Welcome to the first part of the three lecture series on Thomas Carlyle, which will comprise of his biography, Hero as a Poet and Hero as Men of Letters. I am Dr. Jaya Tiwari, Professor of English, Government DB Girls PG College, Raipur. We begin with Carlyle's biography first. He was a Scottish essayist, translator, philosopher, social critic and a thinker who was born on 4th of December 1795 at Ecclefechan in the Galloway region of Scotland. He studied for some time at NN Academy, but as he was bullied there, he left it after 3 years. Then he went to Edinburgh University. He wanted to become a minister first, but later on became a mathematical teacher and later on decided to take up writing as a full-time career. He was married to Jane Bally Welch. Later on, he was elected as rector at the Edinburgh University in the year 1865 and he died on 5th of February 1881. Coming to the major influences that shaped him as the intellectual writer that he was, we find the first influence was from his family only. His father, James Carlyle's Calvinism, a belief that everything, that human being is saved by God only and not on his own merits. This is Calvinism. So initially he believed in this idea. And the second influence, everlasting influence, was of Bible, and we also come across in almost all of his writings allusions and references of Bible in his various works. Later on, he became very much interested in German literature and scholars, and he read almost all of them, and he was so influenced that it, you know, the impact of these writers can be seen very clearly in almost all of his works. He was influenced by Kant, Hegel, Fichte, Goethe, Richter, Schelling, etc. He also knew a number of languages like Italian, Greek, German, Spanish and Danish. So far as his major works are concerned, the first notable work is in the form of a philosophical and semi-autobiographical novel, Sartor Resartus, and which means The Tailor Retailored. Now this is actually a novel which spoke a lot about Victorian England of contemporary times. Victorian age was an age of a number of major political as well as social changes due to industrialization and various other factors. And in that context, we find that democracy was also emerging as a strong, form of government, and Carlyle was somewhat against democracy and the increasing materialistic temper, and therefore we find a kind of comment on the materialistic tendency of the contemporary generation of England was attacked or rather commented upon by Carlyle in this novel Sartor Resartus. Then it was followed by the French Revolution, a history, a very notable work by Thomas Carlyle in 3 volumes, in which he refers to the changes that are taking place again in England and Europe, and these changes are not merely, as I said, political, but they were also thought-provoking changes, social changes, which the whole society was changing, and
which was very somewhat difficult for Carlyle to accept that, and he kept on commenting through his works about them. Later on he became interested in history, or you can say that history was part of his writings. Therefore, he wrote a number of biographies, works on history, that is past and present. Then he wrote The Life of John Sterling. He also wrote on Frederick III and the famous work Heroes, Hero Worship and the Heroic in History. Now, Carlyle is known for his distinct kind of writing. And distinct kind of writing, by this I mean that his writing is so abrupt and scholarly that at times it becomes difficult to understand. Apart from his scholarship, he is also known for his distinct writing style, which is known as Carlyle's. Now, it is because at times he becomes difficult to understand, and therefore, the difficulty to understand him, the complexity and the kind of words and images that he uses makes him a difficult writer, and that is why people referred his style as Carlyle's. Apart from this, he is also known for, there are two peculiar things which must be discussed while discussing Thomas Carlyle, because in Sartor Resartus, he has used the term the everlasting no, means the disbelief in, total disbelief in God, and everlasting yes, which is a kind of transformation which he passes through from disbelief to God to from doubt to faith, that means belief in God. So these are the two peculiar things. As a mathematician, he is known for Carlyle circle, a method used for quadratic equations. Similarly, in the field of economics, he has coined the term decimal signs. And again, coming back to literature, we find in the essay which we are going to deal in the coming lectures, he talks about his concept of the great man theory. So when we look at him, we hardly find any literary figure having such a kind of intellect like that of Thomas Carlyle. He has influenced a number of authors like Charles Dickens, George Eliot and others. I stop here. I hope that you will be profited by this lecture of mine. We will continue in the coming lectures. Thank you very much.